Good morning, students. Welcome to today's information technology class. So we are studying about the chapter data entry and keyboarding skills. So we are mainly talking about how to effectively use your keyboard to make a fast typing or to become a touch typist. Are you clear with the concept? That's good. In the last class, we studied about different types of keys in the keyboard. Right, so alphanumeric keys, function keys, shift key, control key, alt key, and numeric keypad, right? All type of punctuation keys, all types of keys we have studied. And today we are going to start with a pointing device. So do you know which is a pointing device? Of course, it's a mouse, right? There are many pointing devices are there, like a joystick. Okay, trackball, touch screen, okay. So normal mouse. There are n number of pointing devices are there. We are going to talk about the mouse today. So mouse is one of the pointing devices. So what purpose we use a mouse? We use keyboard to type. Mouse to make any comments. If you want to click on the any menus, comments, okay, or if you want to do any activity, without the help of keyboard, okay, without the shortcut keys, if you want to copy a particular object or a text, you can use the comments. For using those comments in the screen, you have to use the mouse. The mouse pointer will help you, right? So when you move the mouse pointer move around the directions wherever you move. That everyone knows. That's a common concept, right? Okay, so we are going to study about this mouse only. And as you know, the mouse has three buttons. So do you know what are the buttons? Left button, right button, and middle scroll button will be there. Scroll button, okay? So three buttons are there in the mouse. So normally we keep our hand like this, right? So I'll show you the picture, how to hold the mouse, okay? So the left button, it's useful to draw, to select, or to point something. And what about right button? Right button, it's useful to get some comments. When you right click on the screen, you will get a pop-up. And you can select any comments what you need and you can work accordingly. Okay. Then scroll button to move up or down to the page. If your document it's not fitting on the entire on the particular screen which you are looking, and if it has a lot of pages, then you can use a scroll button to move up to the page and move down to the page. Got it? So this is the way we use a mouse, and all the mouses by default configured to use it by a right hand users. And if you are a left hand user, you can go to settings in your computer and you can change the configuration to a as a left-hand user. That is possible. Okay, so this is all about the mouse, and let's see how to keep the fingers or hand, right hand, in your mouse. So I'll show you the document and we will study the same. As I said, students, you can see a typical mouse over here. Okay, follow my cursor. So this is a mouse which has a left button, right button, and this is a scroll wheel, or we can call it as a scroll button. So this is the way the mouse looks like, and how to hold the mouse. How to hold the mouse. You can see the pictures over here. So these are the things. The left side, whatever it's given, it's an incorrect method of holding the mouse. Then how we should hold it. See the right method. Okay. So your thumb finger should be on the side of the mouse. It should not be on top of the mouse. It should be on the side. Side panel, it should be there. It should hold the side panel, and remaining second finger, this finger, index finger, will be on the left mouse button. Then this middle finger, okay, so this middle finger is on the it's not on the scroll bar, it is on the right button. Okay, these two buttons fingers are on the right button. Okay, if you want, you can move it to the scroll button also, the middle finger to the scroll button also. So this is the way, and again the side pan, you have to keep this finger, small one. Okay, so this is the way you have to hold your mouse. And if you are doing like this, these are the incorrect methods. please avoid it hereafter. You have to hold it in the same way. This is the right way of holding the mouse. Clear? Good. Let's see the mouse operations. So as you know, there are different types of mouses are there. Different types of mice are there. So trackball is there. You can see at the bottom, you can see a ball on some mouses. In some mouses, there won't be any ball, but a light stream will be passes through. Okay. Then if you take a laptop, you can see the touch pad. So there are different types of mice, but whatever type of mice, but the functionality, it's going to be the same. Maybe the type differs, but we can achieve the task what we need, exactly what we need through all type of mice. Got it? Okay. And if you see the track ball, which has a ball at the back side, okay, and if you see the another type of mouse, which passes the light beams, okay, and you have to walk it on a flat surface. And also in a laptop also, you have a flat surface. And sometimes with a very short stick for performing some job at mouse, you can see. The mouse buttons are used to do different activities. Like we have a left mouse button, we have a right mouse button, and we have a scroll wheel. So if you take a left mouse button, what is its purpose? So if it's a left mouse, you can just point out something. You can just use the left mouse button to click and drag, select something, drag something, or move something. Okay, that is the use of left mouse button. And if you take a right mouse button, if you do a right click, what happens? It brings the pop-up menu. It brings the pop-up menu. So there are different types of mouse operations are there. That is what we are going to see now. The very first one, it's click or left click. So what is mean by click or left click? Using your index finger. Using your index finger, you are just clicking on left button. So to move your cursor to a particular place, you move the mouse and click on a particular place. So single click or left click, we can call it as. So when you click, you will get an insertion point over there. Okay. Or to select a particular item also, you can just click on it. If you have a pictures or a word art or something in your page, you can just make a single click. So that will be selected. That is called left click or single click. Then the second type of mouse operation is double click. So double click, it's to start any program. So if you have any application, see, let me minimize this. So to minimize also, we are using a mouse left button. Okay. I have a browser. So if I want to use a browser, what I do? To open this program, I just double click on it. When I double click, it is getting open. Got it? So double click to start any applications or any programs, we are using double click. Then right click. So right click. So what we do with right click? See, I'm just do a right click. When I do a right click, do you see one set of comments are appearing? Okay, refresh the page, print, save, back, forward, cast media to device, read loud. So many options are there. So which displays a set of comments? Okay, set of comments and available options for that particular place where you clicked on it. And if you see, if I click here on the desktop, right click, I can see set of comments, different set of comments. That depends upon the place where you are clicking. Okay. All right, that is called right click. And when you do the right click, which finger you use it? The middle finger. The middle finger, right button, you just click on it, double click on it. Okay, single click, you single click on it. Okay, then drag and drop. So drag and drop means you're moving particular object or a text from one place to another place. So what do? So you can move an item. First, you have to click on the place where you have an object. Okay. Then you have to hold down the left mouse button and then you have to drag it. And wherever you need, once you reach the destination, you have to leave the left mouse button. That means the object will be dropped into a new position. So that is called drag and drop. Drag and drop means moving an item from one place to another place. For that, which finger we use? Left mouse button, index finger. Clear? Okay. The next one is a scroll. So as I said scroll, see here in this page I have a scroll button. I can scroll up or down wherever I need, right? So if you are not using a scroll button, what you can do is you can go with scrolls on the mouse. You have a scroll buttons in your mouse, you can just use a scroll button. Clear? Okay. Then blocking. Blocking, it's nothing but selecting a particular text or object. Okay. So it is another way of selecting a text. So don't think that what is meant by blocking. It is something like a selecting something, selecting some text or object. Okay. So if you want to do some changes to a text or a object or anything, you have to block it. Means click and drag it until you need using the left mouse button. Okay, which is called blocking. And once, if you want to select a particular thing, what you have to do with, just make a left click, click and drag it wherever you need. You have to stop, hold, take the finger from the mouse. That is called blocking. Is it clear? That's good. So now we studied about the pointing device called mouse. Pointing device called mouse. And for what purpose we are using the mouse? We are using the mouse to select an object, okay, to draw lines, shapes or anything, and to move the objects. There are different types of pointing devices like a mouse, trackball, okay, then a light pen, a joystick, touchpad, touch screen. These are all pointing devices, but here we are talking about the normal mouse. Okay, the normal mouse, some mouse has at the back side, it has a ball, track ball. And in some mouse, it has a light which sends the light beams. Okay, but the mouses are different. The mices are different, but the working behavior, it's going to be the same. If you left click, right click, everything, it's going to be the same, but maybe the structure differs. That's what we studied. Then we studied about different types of mouse operations like a click, click or left click, double click, right click, drag and drop, scroll and blocking. Is it clear for everyone? That's good. So these are the different types of mouse operations. Clear? Well, next move on to typing ergonomics. Next, let's see about typing ergonomics. So we are moving on to keyboard now. Okay. So if you follow the typing ergonomics we are going to discuss now, you can achieve and maintain accuracy and speed in your typing. So the ergonomy is that much important while typing. If you sit in a proper way and if you hold the mouse in a proper way, then definitely you can achieve a high speed typing. Okay, so that's the reason we say that this typing ergonomics always give a logistic support for effective and efficient typing. Typewriting, okay. So that's what we're going to say now. First, let's see the sitting posture. How to sit in front of the computer, especially with the keyboard and mouse, how to hold it. So do you see the picture over here? Yes, see how does the person it sits in front of the computer? First, see, the desk should be approximately 680 to 720 millimeter high. So the desk should be 680 to 720 millimeter high. It should be above our hip level. It should be above our hip level. Okay, then next one. Elbow should be slightly higher than wrist when operating keys and mouse. Elbows should be slightly higher than wrist and wrist when operating with the keys, keyboard and mouse. See, always you have to keep the wrist and see, when we operate, the elbows should be slightly higher than our wrist. Then only we can achieve faster typing. Also, we can type it for a long time without any pain on our hands. Sometimes if you keep your hands like this and type, definitely this part will pain. You cannot type it for a long time. So always the elbows should be slightly higher than your wrist part. Okay, so if you hold it like this, you can do a faster typing. If you do like this, then that means the elbow is lower than the wrist. See, the wrist is here, the elbow is here. So you can see how much distance it has, right? So if you maintain a proper distance, okay, then you can achieve a faster typing. Then the back support should be at an angle of 90 to 100 degree and supporting the lumbar curve. Okay, the back should be at least an angle of 90 to 100 degree. So you can see here, this is a back. Okay, so at least 90 to 100 degree supporting the lumbar curve. Then next one, the hip. The hip should be slightly higher than the knees. See, knees are here, okay, and which is slightly, the hip is slightly higher than the knees. Okay, don't keep your legs like this. Okay, so it should not, the hip always should be higher than the knees. That's a proper position. Then if you see the feet, feet should be rested on the floor, or you can keep it on the footrest on the table. Then there should be approximately 2 to 3 finger width clearance between the front edge of the seat and the back of the knee. See, this is the front edge of the seat, okay, and here this is the knee. So you can see at least 2 to 3 inches difference, 2 to 3 fingers difference you can see. So this much distance you have to give while sitting in front of the computer. Okay, so we might be sitting as we like, but we are not supposed to do that. We have to follow all these procedure while sitting in front of the computer. If we do so, we can sit for a long time and work on a computer for a long time. And if we change our positions, we will become lazy, or we may get pain somewhere in our body, then the totally everything will be collapsed. Okay, so always follow the correct sitting posture while sitting on a computer. I mean sitting in front of the computer, okay? Then position of hands. How to keep your hands? Already I said the hands, the elbows should be slightly higher than the wrist. Slightly higher than the wrist. Okay, so you can see the correct posture here. See, how does this girl is keeping? This is a right posture and this is a wrong posture. Wrong way of sitting. This is a correct screen angle view. Okay, then next one. How to place the monitor? These are the things you have to read it carefully. Do not bend your neck while working on the computer and keep the upper border of screen at eye level. So you have to keep the upper border of the screen, okay, the top of the screen at your eye level. Okay, you are not supposed to bend down, bend your neck and type. Okay, it should be straight. Your eyes and the top of the monitor should be, screen should be equal in length, the same height you have to hold it. The distance of the screen from the user depends on the size of the screen also. Keep an approximately the distance you have to keep up, it's 60 to 65 centimeters for 17 inches screen. Your screen, if your screen is 17 inches, then you have to keep up the distance of, that is between you and the screen, 60 to 65 centimeters. Then mouse and keypad placement. Okay, so keep the always the distance between the mouse and the keyboard should be 20 centimeters in between. If you keep it if you keep a distance between a keyboard and a mouse 20 centimeters, then you can just go with a smooth and effortless operations on the computer. You can go smoothly work on it. Okay, if you keep it very closer, no, you will be having a problem with moving your mouse. So always have a 20 centimeter distance in between the keyboard and mouse. Okay, then chair and table placement. So adjust the chair and table to an optimal height. Okay, so the height you have seen, right, it should be above our hip level. The chair of the computer user must be supportive to the lower back, and it should support our lower back. And keyboard and vibrating devices like printers and other devices should be, fax machine, we have to keep it on another table. Don't keep everything on the same computer table. Okay, only the monitor, okay, keyboard and mouse keep it on the table, then CPU you may keep it down on the rack, okay, or the printing devices like a fax machine, printer also you have to keep it in another table. You should have a sufficient space on your table, okay? Not to throw the books here and there. You have to keep it, maintain the cleanliness on the table also. And also do not eat in front of your computer. Keep your plate and eat in the computer table, okay, which will damage your computer. If you drop any food particles, definitely with or without our knowledge, the ants will get inside to the keyboard, mouse and everything, and they will just break the wires inside. Then you have to buy a new keyboard and mouse. So never ever have your food in front of the computer table. Okay, that's my kind request. Then placement of matter to be typed. So if you are typing something from a textbook or a piece of paper, where you have to keep the matter to be. The place of the matter for typing to the left or right side of the keyboard, preferably on a copy holder which has a sloping surface. So you have to keep it on a sloping surface. You can keep it on, that depends upon you. You may be comfortable with the left side, or sometimes you may be comfortable with the right side. Okay, that you can do it. Next, let's see positioning of fingers on the keyboard. So as I said, in a keyboard, the alphabets are in three rows, right? Top row, middle, and then bottom row. So now we are going to see how to keep our fingers, position the fingers on the keyboard. Okay,